In this video, you will see a few slightly harder examples involving computations with determinants. You will see two small proofs. Always nice to have some examples how a proof actually looks. And we'll also compute the determinant of a matrix with a lot of parameters. You can follow the recipe, of course, but that would lead to a very hard computation. This one can be done a lot easier, as you'll see in the example. But let's start with the proofs. If A and B are square matrices, n times n matrices, then in general A times B is not equal to B times A. However, we can show that the determinants of A times B and B times A are the same. Why is that? Well, you have the rule for n by n determinants that the determinant of A1 times A2 equals determinant A1 times determinant A2. And we will apply that rule twice. We start with the determinant of A times B. We know that the determinant AB equals that A times that B, so we use the rule. Then that A and that B are just numbers, so you can invert order there, so that A times that B equals that B times that A. And then we apply our rule again, that AB equals that A times that B, but now with B times A, so that of B times A equals that B times that A, so we get that B times that A equals that BA, and then there we are, we have that AB equals the determinant of B times A. So even though AB and B are not the same, they are different matrices, still the determinants are the same. Let's take a look at a second proof. If the matrix A is invertible, so in particular it's a square matrix, an invertible matrix, then the determinant of A inverse equals 1 over that A. Well, why is that? Well, A is invertible, so A times A inverse is the identity matrix. Then we can take determinants on left and right hand side, so the determinant of A times A inverse equals the determinant of the identity matrix. Well, the identity matrix is the matrix if it's only once on the diagonal and zeros otherwise. So the determinant is just 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 equals 1. So now we know that the determinant of A times A inverse equals 1, but we can split it up again as we did in the previous proof, that of A times A inverse equals that A times that A inverse, which we'll do over here. And then we can solve for the determinant of A inverse, because A is invertible, so that A is not equal to 0, so you can divide by it. So that of A inverse equals 1 over the determinant of A, which was what we had to show. Let's go to the example. Well, this example looks horrible. We have a matrix A, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, G, H, I, with 9 parameters, and the only thing we know is that the determinant of A equals 7. Then we have another matrix B, which looks even more complicated, and the question is, can we compute the determinant of B? Well, you don't want to use any expansion or so, any direct computations, but you really have to be a bit smarter here. Well, suppose we start with A. Can we get B by doing some row operations? Because if we can, we know how to compute the determinant of B because we know what row operations do with a determinant. So let's start with A and see whether we can get B. Well, first of all, we can add the first row 2 times to the second row. Then A looks already a bit more like B. Let's call that one B1. Then you see, if we want to get closer to B, we have to change the first and the third row, and then we get to B2, and we see we are almost at B. And if we multiply this last row by minus 6, we are at B3, and you see that the matrix B3 equals matrix B. So by three operations, by the three row operations, we can get our B from our A. So what happens with the determinant? Well, we got B3 out of B2 by multiplying one row by minus 6, which means that we get the determinant of B3 out of the determinant of B2 by multiplying the determinant of B2 by minus 6. We got B1 out of B2 by interchanging one row, which means we get the determinant of B2 out of B1 by multiplying by minus 1. So determinant B2 equals minus 1 determinant of B1. And we got the determinant of, we got B1 out of A by adding a multiple of a row, so that doesn't change the determinant. So that B1 equals the det of A. So we get the determinant of B3, which equals the determinant of B, equals 6 times the determinant of A, equals 42. So you see, if you can apply row operations in order to compute determinants, then the computations are usually a lot easier than by just expanding along a row or a column.